Hi everyone. In this session we are going to see voltage regulator. So you may remember till now we are seeing regulated DC power supply, and this was the basic block diagram for regulated DC power supply, where first one AC line, then transformer, rectifier. This one we have seen, bridge rectifier. The next one is filter. This also we have seen, capacitor filter, how it is working. So input was an alternating current. After rectifier, this pulsated DC. Then after filter, most of the pulse we have removed. But anyway, there is some ripples are there. There is a small portion of AC component still now present. That is, a small frequency component exists here. So how we can remove this one? For that one, already I told you different types of filters are there: inductor filter, LC filter, inductor and capacitor filter, pi filter, that is capacitor, resistor, capacitive filter, that is CRC filter. Like the different types of filters are there, and even though we are using different types of filter, there is small portion of the AC will exist, that is ripples, it will exist. To remove those AC component, normally we are using regulator. So I think all of you familiarize with this regulator. So the regulator, normally we are seeing stabilizer. In the case of fridge, then TV, we are using stabilizer. Actually, the basic heart of this stabilizer, it is voltage regulation, voltage regulator. So first we can see what is voltage regulator, or what is the basic working principle of voltage regulator. The basic working principle of voltage regulators is based on Zener diode. So, already I told you, since even though the rectified signal, it is DC, we are saying DC, there is some portion of AC, that is, ripples will be present. To remove such ripples, we are using voltage regulators. Normally, the basic component of this voltage regulator is Zener diode. So, Zener diode voltage regulator we are going to see. This is working based on the basic principle. Zener diode provides a constant voltage when operate in the reverse breakdown region, irrespective of current through it and variation in the applied voltage. That is, whatever the applied voltage or whatever the current passing through it, it will provide a constant voltage across this diode. So it is acting as a voltage regulator, whatever the situation. Then, how it is acting as a voltage regulator? So, to see this one, we can see first one, the breakdown diodes. So you may know, normal diode cara, it is somewhat like this. You know, normal diode cara. Here it is forward bias, and in forward bias, it is somewhat like this diode cara, and in reverse bias, normal diode, I am saying normal diode, this small reverse saturation current will be there, then there is sharp breakdown. So normally in forward bias, this is the region where it can operate. There is actually forward breakdown, we are not considering that one. That is the maximum current that can permit via device in forward bias. Okay, anyway, there is a reverse breakdown voltage. up to this region one diode can operate in safety. If it is going beyond this region, diode will get damaged and its proper function will lose. So that is in normal case of a diode. But here, the breakdown diode, what we are normally using, it is in breakdown diode, it can operate in this reverse bias region. That is, normal diode, it cannot operate in this region, that is reverse breakdown region. But Zenor diode or breakdown diode, it can operate in this reverse bias breakdown region. Such diodes generally known as breakdown diodes or Zenor diode. It is known as Zenor diode, the reason why, because the scientist Zenor invented this phenomena. Then it is believed that Zenor effect is the cause of this phenomena. Later invented that not only Zenor effect, there is one more effect is there, avalanche effect, that also cause for this phenomena, that is that one diode can operate in reverse bias breakdown region. So generally you can say a breakdown diode or a Zenor diode, the name is Zenor or breakdown, both are same. Okay, breakdown or Zenor diode, both are same name. Okay, either you can use breakdown diode or the Zenor diode. This diode is working based on the phenomena. It can be two, either it can work based on Zenor effect or it can work based on avalanche effect. Or it can work based on avalanche effect. Means this avalanche and Zenor effect, these two are the phenomena that is happening in a breakdown diode or Zenor diode. Never think that Zenor diode shows Zenor effect. Zenor diode, it is the name for the device or equipment. So another name is breakdown diode, and it can shows two phenomena. It is Zenor or avalanche, Zenor effect or avalanche effect. In same diode, these two phenomena simultaneously may happens or may not happens. Anyway, as the doping concentration increases, it will show Zenor effect, and as the doping concentration decreases, it will show avalanche effect. And for Zenor effect, if doping concentration increase, this breakdown voltage, this voltage will decrease. So for Zenor effect, breakdown voltage will be small, and avalanche effect, breakdown voltage will increase. And in the middle region, that diode may shows both effects, Zenor and avalanche effect together. And I already told you why it happens. So it is the reason. First invented Zenor effect and we give the name Zenor diode. Later we invented not only Zenor effect, avalanche effect also goes for this breakdown diode. Then we can see detail about this Zenor diode. So, already these things are explained here. Breakdown voltage is function of the doping concentration. As the doping concentration increases, breakdown voltage will decrease. And then we just saw what is Zener effect and Zener diode. We can see, I think already you know what is Zener effect and what is Avalanche effect. And to easily understand, we can say if we are taking one diode, if you are taking one diode and if it is in reverse bias and we connected battery across this one, this reverse bias, we connected battery, this is P region, this is N region, P and N region, then due to the apply of this electric field, that is high reverse bias electric field, the electrons in the bonded atom, covalent bonded atom, if one atom is here and electron is sharing by two atom, so this is the covalent bond sharing by two atom. If this electron is removed or escaped due to this high electric field, this electron is escaped from here and coming to this part, and there is one hole formed. So if one electron is escaped from the covalent bond or break the covalent bond and result in the condensation, such a phenomena we are known normally known as field ionization, and that is the fundamental reason for Zener effect. But for avalanche effect, it is caused by the impact ionization. How it is happened means, if we same way, this is P side and this is N side, we are connecting one battery. So this due to this high negative charge, the electron is rippled from here, this electron rippled, and it is moving with very speed, very high speed, and it is colliding this atom, this it is colliding this electron, and this electron escaped from here and one hole formed. Then these two electrons is again attracted by this high positive charge, and meanwhile it is collided with another electron, and that electrons also get released from them, somewhat like this. This electron collide like that. So this is due to the collision. This is known as impact ionization. This is the fundamental reason of avalanche effect. So it can be Zener effect or avalanche effect by that one Zener diode is operating. Then we are going to see how this breakdown diode or Zener diode, it is helped to for voltage regulator, that we can see in the next video. Thank you.